to blame to insinuate or even
No.
try to interpret that as great. Do you know what I mean?
No, I
Because at
don't.
the end of the
Although
day,
you see, I disagree with what Berman said, is that has called him a grapist. I do don't
yeah,
agree.
that's the only thing. Yeah, that's the only
Yeah.
thing that I would say would be, yeah,
Yeah,
definitely. That's not.
that was
That's not. Yeah.
in a heated argument where someone's fucking threatening to come to my house, and it wasn't just in a normal. It's not that I'm calm headed and that I hadn't slept all night. I've been accused of outing this all night. I'm not thinking straight.
Birdman, to be
And
fair,
that's
did
when
you
I
not
said it,
ask him to come to your house?
and I have apologized for that.
But
Sorry.
to be fair, Birdman, did you not invite him to come to your house?
No, he said he'd come, and then I said, "Come on, then," innit?
No.
All right. So he the one incited all of that in the first.
Birdman, I'm going to have to say, though, that Bally moment had me dead. I can't. It killed me.
That was that. You know what? That was the third time because I kept coming back online. And everyone saying, "Oh, he's over here now. Go there." So that was the third freaking time that I had gone out. Yeah, and obviously he was not at any of the places, which is a good
But
thing.
Birdman, Birdman, my darling, you put the balaclava on your live and then went out to do something.
My brain wasn't working, and I hadn't slept. I was sleep deprived. Everyone was coming for me saying, "You friggin' outed this, you're so wrong, you're a cancel." Listen, and I was up all night, keep freaking defending myself. It was too early, man, and my brain wasn't working properly.
Yeah.
But he wasn't, one thing I will say, my DJ Decor playing the Billy Big Bollocks wasn't cool because he did that for Twitch 2 minutes and drove off. He wasn't even at the location.
Birdman, don't start this again. He'll get back
but
in his bloody
will.
Car.
You see now that
and hopefully this
done.
Time he stays and actually meets me and doesn't just do it for the internet, right? That'd be good, innit?
Well, do you know what? I think he's having beef over a situation. I can see why he's defending his friends to some extent. You're defending because what you've been told is the truth, or what you
Haley, I haven't defended any of it. Like, I haven't said what she said is true. I haven't said, I haven't even brought it to the app. But then once it's brought to the app, people are saying, "I've accused him of rape." I've like, hang on, no, I haven't. All I've said is what I've done, which is privately speak to somebody and ask them, "Someone's told me this information. What shall I do with this information?"
Yeah.
Shall
I report it to the police?
That's all I've asked
for. I don't think this woman should have brought it to the app, full stop, whether it's true or not. You
yeah,
know what I mean? Because,
it,
she should know she's going to get crucified for that. So you can't blame people for disbelieving her either. You know, she's got no evidence, which I do understand. You're not always going to have evidence for that shit. And she has caused all this, really, by bringing it to the app in the first place. You know, you just take it to the police. If you don't take it to the police, then you don't bring it to social media.
Exactly that.
And it's like, well, it's a bit like the scenario. Birdman comes to me, tells me something, and
yeah.
I don't know how to handle it. So then I message Hustle, and
yeah.
I say to him, "Hustle, let's have a chat. Birdman's come to me, and he's told me this, and I'm not sure how to handle it, right?" Hustle
yeah.
gives me advice.
Yeah, but then goes and does something else.
Someone, the person that has been spoken about.
Yeah.
If all he done was try to be a medium and get some help for her,
yes.
And it's blown up in his face.
Thank you very much, man. Finally, somebody gets it.
Yeah, that is what happened. But what I will say is when I do say from Rihanna's perspective, I don't think she did it from a bad place, bro. Like so with JC, she supports JC, innit? So she's gone to him thinking like, "Yo,
no,
what the fuck? I don't want to." Wait, one second, bro. Because she
what?
Even said to you, "I want to know the name because I don't want to be supporting a grapist." She said that, right?
Yeah, she kept saying that for 2 days, yeah?
So once she's known the name, then she's gone to him and saying, "Yo, I hope this isn't true," kind of thing.
But she also did try and, like, why did she try, yeah, and try and message me and say, "Oh, I feel really sorry, but I'm just saying it now, innit?" She messaged me on Snapchat saying, "Oh, I feel really sorry for the girl. Is she okay?" When she already knew she spoke to JC, and then she said that
the reason she did that to get evidence for JC,
that I'm spreading it.
Say it again. Sorry, I couldn't hear you with that echo.
No, I didn't tell Rihanna that she was a rapist. I told Rihanna. So I spoke, who's the person, I said, "Look, someone's told me this, what shall I do?" And I told her that what somebody had told me, but I didn't say any names. Do you get it? I told her what Alicia had told me. So how am I saying? I haven't said that. I didn't use the word grapist, did I? She's thought he's a grape is from what Alicia's story, what she said to me, and then what she explained to me, and I explained it to her.
And that's it. Everybody's read these messages. Birdman got the messages. He's put his own interpretation on it. He's then gone to a female that he trusts, spoke to her. She's put her interpretation in it. It's a bit like the Chinese whispers now. Do you know what I mean? And there's more people here. It's getting bigger with other people's interpretation on it.
So, Birdman, did you never say the grape word to Rhiannon?
No, right. I just told her what I think. I just said, look, this is what somebody had told me, innit?
Right.
I've advised them to go to the police, but like, and that's.
Oh, you did on the call. Remember, you played the recording.
Which recording?
But she. So what he said is, so Alicia never actually said that directly to him. She told him what happened, and then he has said, "Yo, that is the definition of art."
Yeah.
She said the action in it, which is like very graphic, and what she did say basically is what he's defining it is. So yeah.
No, she's saying hustle. She just accusing him of attempted kind of that, or she's accusing him of that, but hasn't
no,
she?
No, I don't know. You didn't, no, I didn't have that combo.
Yeah, so it's completely
fake.
So
I don't know. That's a question for Burma. I don't know. Did she say he did that or he attempted?
She said he did, didn't it?
No.
So then, if you
she said it happened. Do you guys keep wanting me to say the same thing? I've said it so many times, like, you know what I mean? And I don't even want to be saying it on the app, to be honest with you. Like,
I think there's two different things, though, Birdman. So there's a... there's an actual grape, or was there something within the intercourse that led her to say it was grape? Was there something done that she didn't want, but she actually consented to intercourse? Does that make sense? There's two different scenarios, isn't there? She's consented to it, and something happened within that consent that she didn't want to happen, or did she not want the whole thing to happen?
But at the end of the day, the minute she said...
Do you think you need to ask her?
Yeah, no.
You haven't seen the rest of this video.
Well, how do I know? Like, she told me that. She goes that, like, it's very... Like, she told me that she kept saying no, 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 and the guys keep forcing herself on her, and then obviously eventually it happened and she went to sleep fucking crying. It's very disturbing. I would like if, I've said it so many times, so... I don't want to keep repeating this shit because it's
I will say, yeah, look, to be honest, all of the pressure on, you know how it is when you're under pressure, right? And all of the pressure on Birdman to relay a story that he's been told is like, really, I think it needs to come out of the horse's mouth, bro, because this is ridiculous.
Yeah, exactly. Shall I play the video for people? Because some people wanted me to replay it. Should I just replay it?
To anyone for me to say anything on live, it's not fair to me, it's not fair to JC, and it's not, I don't really care about Birdman, to be fair. And it's definitely been no, I don't really know what to say on the situation. I've just told JC everything I told Birdman on the phone. I told him everything. I told Birdman the truth. I've done my bit. Respectfully, I feel like it's a bit irrelevant me sitting on here and telling all you lot. You need to clear. I've already been on here and said I did not say those words what the Birdman's saying. I've already said that.
See what I mean? She's not saying, someone in the comments said Clara's name. She says, well, I just said it wasn't great. It wasn't a word. So she's not saying it's enough.
Yeah, and I haven't said that word, though, the grape word. JC came on the app and said that, like, the only time I've said the grape word, like, said it when I'm arguing DJ to call after, but these guys were talking about it before, innit? So,
See that part where she said I told Birdman the truth is a bit shaky. Like, do you know what I'm saying? What does that even mean?
Yeah. Only to DG I said that, obviously. But this was before all of that shit, innit?
That's what I said.
Oh, sorry, Hayley. I think she's.
Hey, Birdman, can I ask you a question, please?
Yeah, who's that? Sorry.
It's Nikki.
Hi, Nikki.
Hi. I'm just wondering why you sat on it for a month and why. Well, I know you can't answer for Rihanna. Why she sat on it for a week? Because like, if somebody came to me with that, I'd find it really disturbing and I wouldn't be able to sit on it.
I told her to report it.
Yeah, but it's not, is that Birdman's responsibility? Because that's her story, right?
I wasn't going to ever bring it to the app, though.
I don't mean bring it to the app.
The only reason, obviously, you can imagine, knowing this for over, it's like 3 weeks, I think, to a month, yeah? And you can imagine, I've got shit going on in my own life, but then sometimes, and when me and Rihanna spoke, something like a similar scenario was mentioned. So then it reminded me, and I was like, you know what? Somebody had told me this, and like from time to time, I did think that, like, is she okay? Like, you know what I mean?
I don't know,
no one's ever told me this before, and you don't get taught what to do in this.
No, situation. I just mean, did you check up on her and check that she was okay and everything?
Yeah. Well, not as much as I should have, because like we went on live together and we kind of like just, we had the argument where you see the video in it about 2 weeks later when I said, don't get onto me, you should get onto JC, where everyone's trying to say, oh, that's when I bought it to the app, but that was a week and a half.
Guys, it's not Birdman's story, do you understand? It's not for him to bring it to the app or even him to go to the...
No, I don't mean bring it to the app, and I mean, like, if one of my friends told me that,
so what should,
like that, I would...
Do you think I should have gone
to
the police? What do you think I should have done in it? Because I don't, like, and everybody else watching as well.
If somebody tells you this, what should we do?
Because maybe we can all learn right now.
Even take her to the police.
Do you know what it is, Nikki? I hear you, yeah? I actually hear what you're saying, but also, at the end of the day, like, they've not spoken over a year. He's not her babysitter. Like, I understand it's sensitive information, but, like, what do you expect him to do? He's got his own life that he's living.
Yeah, it's not for the Birdman to take it to the police. It's for her. She might not want to take it to the police.
Rihanna up, because you don't know Rihanna to feel comfortable to tell her this story. I'm not going to lie.
But listen, you don't know what personal conversation
Rihanna's told me you only knew her for 2 days. But, so why do you feel comfortable telling somebody that you knew? Hold on, let me land. Why do you feel comfortable telling somebody, regardless of the conversation?
Why is Rihanna comfortable telling me what led to that conversation?
Can you let me land? If this was true, this is serious trauma and somebody's, like, it's real life shit.
I would have said Rihanna up, I don't get
you're
that.
You're not letting me land because you're clearly getting your back up for some reason. You're not letting
Why
me land.
Would I set Rihanna up? Wow, are you listening to this, people? She's saying
you
I've set Rihanna
up. You knew her for 2 days. Why did you feel comfortable telling Rihanna somebody else's trauma? That's what I'm asking you.
I didn't tell her somebody else's trauma, did I?
Did I mention
the girl's name? No. And did I mention the guy's name? No. I just
but
thought...
But you still told somebody else's trauma for someone that you knew for 2 days. Why?
Because I want to
that's
do it.
Weird.
Because she's speaking about the same situation to me.
But that's still not your. It's not happened to you. Do you
she's
understand
talking,
what I'm saying?
She's talking
you
about a similar situation.
For what you're doing.
Why
you
to about similar situation then to me? I don't get it. That's why this situation, because it made me.
But that's her trauma, right? If it was about her, that's her trauma to tell you. You're saying that Rihanna was speaking about a situation. I'm guessing something that happened to her, right?
No, she's just talking about something similar, innit?
So if it's something to do with her, then it's her trauma for her to tell you. It's not somebody else's. Does that make sense? What I'm trying to, like, this is where you...
Yeah, so I was like...
You should say, do you know what? I should never have told anybody.
What accountability? So I'm wrong
you should
for asking
stand
somebody,
up as a man and
I
say,
do
you know what? I shouldn't have told a stranger that I don't know about somebody else's trauma. Because that's what's caused this. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, I don't get it.
I don't get how you don't understand. It's common sense.
So you're blaming me? Am I, okay, guys, I'm in the wrong for all of this. I'm in the wrong.
You've got somebody, such a victim mentality. It's crazy.
Okay, guys, I'll take accountability.
Nobody's blaming you, but you do need to take accountability for what your part of it. The same way Rihanna said.
Out of all of this, Melissa, what have you got? Out of all of the situation where somebody's come out, they maybe they're saying that somebody's done something to them. Then they're saying no, that person's lying. Then they're saying no, that person's not lying. Out of all of this, you're like Birdman to blame. Nice one.
The only way Rihanna has come out and said, yeah, I've, like, she's taken accountability for what she did. No, you need to do the same thing.
No offense.
You're just a victim. You're just like, Birdman's being blamed. Nobody's blaming you. What I'm saying is, as a man, take accountability and say, I shouldn't have told a random person that I don't know off the internet somebody else's trauma.
Listen, you're putting words up and like twisting the shit. Yeah, I've already said that I should have never spoken to Rihanna because Rihanna did a snake move and wet. And told something.
I don't think it was snake. I think she did the right thing.
I don't think she did the right thing to the others.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Thanks, Andrew.
All right,
thank you, Melissa.
Do you know what it is? Melissa's not blaming you there, you know. She's just letting you know the part she feels you've done wrong.
She did. She just came with a tactical
name. No, bro, listen, you're not getting blamed there. Listen, you have to take the defense down a little bit, bro. I swear to God, bro. I swear. Just sometimes listen.
No, bro, because she's your moderator, so, and she's Rihanna's friend, bro. So it's like, that's what's happening here, by the way, everybody. She's
bro, her and Rihanna don't have conversations.
No, but that's why she's coming up here, like, to back Rihanna's case. Like, if anything, Rihanna also should have not have gone to somebody else in it, because it's Rihanna the one who's bought this on the app, Hustle. When I demodded Rihanna, she's come to you, bro, and she goes, Birdman's talking about the situation.
No, all right, so that's,
and then clarify,
that's not how it went down.
So how did Rihanna end up in your box talking about this situation?
Because me and you spoke on the phone, yeah, for like an hour, and you've seen how my live was, right? Yeah. My live was on mute, and everyone in the chat was wondering what the hell's going on, because you'd come in the chat saying you wanted to speak to me, right? And everyone's wondering what the convo was. And then I've come back, and then I received a message, right, basically saying, yo, this and this, don't get yourself involved in it. And I'm like, I'm getting mad now, thinking, what the fuck? Am I being threatened via message? And I'm getting mad, and everyone's wanting to know what the situation is. But I'm not I'm not saying what's happening, because it's not my business, and it's a very sensitive and private thing. So anyway, then after, in the call me and you have had, I've said to you, yo, don't go live and don't speak about it. And then the next thing, Rihanna's in my comments saying that you're live talking about her. So I'm like, what the fuck? So then she's come in the box, and then she's explaining briefly what's happening. No names have been mentioned. And then JC's come in the comments saying the person that's being mentioned is me. I've got nothing to hide. Then he's come up and spoke about it and said all the names.
So therefore, JC has came and brought it to the app.
I've got a 28-minute recording of you slagging me off and talking about the situation. That's why I went in Russell's box.
Sorry?
I've got a 28-minute recording, screen recording, of you talking about the situation. Then you outed my name. Then I went to Hustle's box.
I'm saying that somebody has told
me. Don't try and blame me for bringing it to the app. I never fucking
told you. What am I talking about? I'm talking about
the whole situation and my name.
I'm talking about you. I've told you something personal and you've outed it to somebody else, so I'm removing you as a moderator.
That's not all you said, though, was it? You said this person A, meaning Alicia, told me something that was so serious, and I said A, B, and C.
I go, someone's told me something.
Yeah.
He's exposed it out to somebody else. So that's.
Yeah, but you said it was a serious accusation. The police should have been involved. And then you outed my name. So I went to Hustle. I said, it's me speaking about. JC was in your life when you were talking about it. That's why he came to Hustle's as well. To say, do you know what? The situation he's mentioning is about me.
Yeah, but I was just saying I'm removing a moderator and I removed you. If you didn't...
That's not the only thing you said, was it?
If you and JC didn't go into Hustle's live and speak about it...
You had already mentioned it.
I was removing you as a moderator because of you snake me. I was telling everybody else the reason I'm removing you as a moderator. So you got so hurt about that.
I'm not bothered about being your moderator. I will demod myself from everybody's live now. I am not asked about it. It doesn't pay my bills. It doesn't make me happy in life. I don't fucking care. A moderator is nothing to me. When you're slating me on a live, that's what bothers me. You didn't even have the fucking audacity to ring me to ask me what happened. You rang me, called me a rat and hung up. Where's the big man mentality there? Because you didn't ask me how it even came about in the conversation with JC.
Hi, can I just say, speak to, hi, Bluebell.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello. I'm here with just a bit of support for Birdman because I don't know, it's, I've watched the whole thing happen and I don't think he's to blame. He is to blame for one thing because he shouldn't have passed on a secret to somebody else. So he was wrong for doing that. But everything else, I don't think he was wrong. Yeah. I don't think he should be getting punished like he's getting punished.
Yeah. Yeah, I think she's getting away with quite well. I say she, I don't know the truth. We don't know the truth, so I can't really say that either. Do you know what I mean? Hi, Woodhill.
She seems to be, one minute she's saying, no, he didn't do it. And then another minute she's saying, yes, he did. So,
you know what, though? I sometimes change, you know what, I'm not defending anyone, but I sometimes change my story and I know I'm telling the truth. And I do that sometimes when I feel I'm under pressure or, you know, my anxiety, or it's like, you know, you say it in the wrong way or, you know, do you know, does it make sense?
Yeah, it is mad though because she said
Birdman's getting the blame for all of it. It seems like
I don't think Birdman should be getting the blame.
It's not fair. It's not
fair. The only thing that's mad to me is that she's saying that he didn't do it, and then she's saying in that clip there that Birdman knows the truth, and then actually in the recording that Birdman's got of him and her, she's saying to Birdman, "I thought I could trust you." Do you know what I'm saying? So it's a bit mad.
Guys, we're just going round and round in circles. At the end of the day, Birdman's tried to stick up for his cell and do the right thing.
Yeah.
DG's tried to do the right thing by his mate. And if this girl is lying, it's ridiculous, but also she could be telling the truth. And we're just going round and round in circles.
Yeah, I think we all fuck up it, but I think Birdman has fucked up with what he called, you know. And he said that at anger. He's also apologised to JC for saying that. And I think that's, you know, and he might have said something he shouldn't have said, do you know what I mean?
But then, yeah, you know, it's a few people, really. Yeah. Taking it further. He shouldn't have spoke to the young girl about it. He should have kept it to himself or reported it to the police or said to the lady that said in the first place, I'm sorry, I'm here as a friend, but if you're that worried about it, you need to speak to the police.
And why would you tell somebody you've not spoken to for over a year something so personal as that?
You wouldn't, would you?
Listen, I'm jumping up now.
You wouldn't talk to Birdman, you talk to your best friend about it. If that happened to me, which it has happened to me, and my best friend, I went to my best friend who helped me and supported me, but in the end, I went to the police and it was dealt with.
Listen, I'm jumping out now, but before I go, I just want to say I don't think Rihanna hasn't done anything wrong. I don't think Birdman done anything wrong before coming to the live and saying the things he said about JC. And that's that. I think it's just involved the two people involved and that's it.
Yeah, exactly.
Honestly, I don't
think no one should be accused. I don't think anyone should be going to this girl and say, calling her any names, because we don't know the truth, do we, right?
No, the only person that knows the truth is him and her. Yeah. They're the only people that know the truth.
You know, we don't know who the
Birdman was wrong for going to Romania about it, and he shouldn't have done. He should have kept it to himself or spoken or to somebody who's more closer to him than somebody that he's only
known. Can I just say one thing before I drop? Is it's not fair, obviously, I've got an issue now with Birdman about mentioning my name and saying what he said to me, but he shouldn't be left taking the heat for her changing her fucking story multiple times.
No, he shouldn't.
He shouldn't.
I sat there and I watched it all last night and I watched it all this morning, and I think it's absolutely disgusting what people are saying about him. And I've been fighting his battle all morning, and I've been telling people to leave him alone. He's done nothing wrong. Yes, he did something wrong by telling you, Rowena. Yeah. And he shouldn't have done. He should have kept it to himself or gone back to the lady and said to her, look, this is your problem. You need to speak to the police and let the police deal with it. Because at the end of the day,
I take accountability. Maybe I shouldn't have gone to JC and said what I said.
No, you shouldn't have done. You
know what I mean?
Yourself, yeah.
But at the end of the day, I was stuck in a tricky position. Like, I was sat there for a week not knowing what to do. Yeah. I didn't know all the names involved. I didn't think he'd know who the girl was if he didn't do it. And at the end of the day, obviously, he figured that out for himself. So, obviously, I've got regrets on my part.
I imagine Birdman has as well. But he's gone through so much just lately. And I think people should just leave him alone.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. He shouldn't be left to take the heat for something that isn't fair.
That woman's told him he shouldn't take the heat for it. It's not fair. And they should
My bad for calling you a rat as well, then, Rihanna, because I just got upset. My bad for calling you a rat, because I just thought I got upset for telling you something, and I just felt like, you know, I get
it. No, I get that. I understand that, obviously.
He's got over 1,000 people telling him that he's wrong, he's doing this, he's doing that. And, of course, he's going to come out and say things to defend himself.
I think what happened is it all got too heated, obviously. Me and Birdman didn't actually speak about how the conversation came about with me and JC. Obviously, he doesn't know, still doesn't know how that came about.
We haven't spoken properly since.
That's what I'm saying. If you want to know, I'm more than happy to tell you how it even came about. But I'm not mentioning it all over the app, because right now I really don't want to be involved anymore. Like, this is something that...
If you're going to do it off the app. Everything should have been done off the app. It shouldn't have been bought to the app. And I don't know who bought it to the app, but the person that did is totally wrong. And they should be the ones
I will say, the person that actually mentioned the R word on the app was JC. Birdman spoke about the issue. I jumped in the box to defend my name. JC came up and then said, he's mentioning this and it's about this grape. Right? He did mention the grape word.
Box all night to fight his battle, but because of what was going on, it was overlooked, so I never managed to get
finally
that.
Somebody's telling the truth, right?
I was just say, JC, Lisa Lee's put JC has gone into hiding. If he's got nothing to hide, you'd prove you're innocent. 100% not. Sometimes it's hard to prove your innocence as well. I'm a believer. If you make an accusation, you're the one that needs to prove that person's guilty, not the person that's innocent. That could be possibly innocent, right? No one else requests the box, because I'm going to come after this, but I'm going to try and get all these people that have been waiting for such a long time.
There's two people.
I got to go now,
No one requests the box, guys. I'm going to let you have your say, though, because it's only fair, because you've been waiting ages, okay? Hen, you're right.
I just wanted to come on and say I don't think Rihanna did anything wrong in the sense of speaking to JC about it. I think JC deserved to know. But I think right now that he has come online and he has said that it's a police matter, and I think it's best that everyone leaves it with the police, because it will just, it will ignite the fire even more and make things worse for both of them involved. So I think it's best now just take the heat off Birdman and Rihanna and everyone else involved and just let them deal with it through the police. Because it can be very dangerous as well on her part and on JC's part, whether, you know, whoever's proving their innocence, it's going to jeopardise their case, do you know what I mean, now? So I think it's best to just not be spoken about in boxes anymore and just leave them to deal with it.
Yeah, I'm going
to
let the last people have definitely. Their say, because I've been waiting a long time, though, okay? Hi, Claire Duffy, all right?
Hi, Andrew. Hello. Hi, gorgeous. I just wanted to talk to Rihanna, but she's dropped down, hasn't she?
Yeah.
My question, well...
Go on, Claire. You never usually lost for words.
Right, last person in the box.
Can I just say something about Birdman, Angie? I absolutely love Birdman. Like, I don't believe that he would ever, like, when I'm seeing the comments about people saying that I've seen things people saying he screen records stuff to out people for it. Birdman knows so much about me, and I know so much personal things about him, and I would trust that he would never, ever out anybody like that. Like, he is not that kind of person. And, you know, I know I'm friends with JC, I'm friends with DG. I believe that they would never do the same. Like, they're not about that. And I just feel a bit... I got a call. Yeah, so I just feel like this has turned into a bit of a witch hunt on Birdman, and it's like he's gone to Rihanna in confidence about this, saying, I don't know what to do. He's seen it from a male's perspective. No, I'm not a fangirl, don't worry. And he's seen it from a male's perspective. I feel like if me as a male getting told something like that, I would be a bit like, shit, what do you do? What do you say? And he's obviously gone to a woman he knows in confidence, and then it's got out the way it has, which obviously isn't amazing. But I just don't believe at all that Birdman would do anything malicious whatsoever to anybody like that. It just mm-hmm. doesn't sit right with me thinking that, because he knows so much about so many people. I know that he does, because people go to him all the time with issues, and I just don't believe for one second that he would do anything to hurt anybody in any way like that.
Not intentionally, anyway.
Andrew, what the fuck are you doing?
I want to say, do you know what the crappy thing is about it? Like, we're sat here and we're all talking about it because it's, like, not our lives. But the unfortunate thing is no matter what the result is, two people's lives are forever tarnished now. So whether it's false or true, it's a horrible situation to be in, because now their names are always going to be tarnished with this, you know? It's a horrible situation for both parties. It's so unfortunate. And as far as, like, the whole police stuff and things like that, she's very calculated with what she's done there, because she's saying, well, I'm not going to phone the police. I don't want them involved. But unfortunately, people know how TikTok work.
Yeah.
And people who are her fans, people who feel sorry for her, they're going to phone the police themselves for her. She knew what saying those words was going to bring. And it's just so unfortunate, because this is people's real lives, you know?
But when she actually told Birdman, did she actually think that it was going to come out? That's the thing. Like, did she call him and or whatever, speak to him and tell him, thinking that it would just stop with him? I mean, he is catching a lot of heat, and he shouldn't really be catching any heat, to be honest. Because at the end of the day, she told him, Alicia told Birdman, he didn't bring it to the app, as it's been proved numerous times. JC was the actual one that mentioned the grape first. So I feel like no one's coming for the girl, no one's going for JC. Birdman is just a messenger. Yeah, I don't understand why, because he's literally relaying on, like, a conversation that he had with Alicia, and Alicia's obviously confirmed that she had this conversation, and he knew things that he wouldn't have got off the app. So obviously a conversation took place. We can't say whether or not it happened, because only the two people involved actually know what happened. So all we're doing is basically just, like, guessing, really. It's a guessing game.
Unfortunately, in a situation like this, as we all know, like, all being adults and stuff, there always has to be a fall guy, right? There always has to be somebody to take the fall when you don't want the heat. It's directed to somebody else. There always has to be a way out.
And as a free call number for is the grape crisis line, and that is the number if anybody does want to write it down, since we're talking about this.
But Birdman has got no reason to say what he's saying if it wasn't true.
Well, so
she's got to be true what she said, because he's not that sort of person that would come out with something like that for no reason at all.
But Birdman has just done what a lot of us do, and use a situation to. He was obviously speaking to Rihanna, which he has already said, and Rihanna was talking about a similar situation. He hasn't said that it was a similar situation with regards to Rihanna, but they were having a private conversation and they were talking about a similar situation. I personally, if I'm talking to somebody in a private conversation and they bring something up, if I've been in a similar situation, he has then used a similar situation. He never mentioned this Alicia, this girl's name. He just said, well, actually, you know, this so thing happened and I didn't know what to do. So then Rihanna has digged him for a couple of days asking who this person's name is, because she doesn't want to be associated with somebody that who could possibly have done something like this.
Yeah.
And she digged him for quite a few days. Birdman didn't want to say the name because he didn't want to get involved, but she did poke him for a few days. The thing Birdman has done wrong is say the name.
Yeah.
That's what he's done wrong, because then he's gone and said to the name, and then Rihanna has then gone on because she knows JC, and then gone on and said this, and this is where this is unfolded, and you know, that's how I see it.
I think we're all just going, like, we're all telling the story again and again and again, and I think it's just I don't know, it's just going round and round in circles now, I feel. Mm. Everybody knows what's happened and we can all make our own conclusions now of what we think about it.
This is her.
Yeah, that's what I mean, like, let's just leave it now.
That's absolutely it. I think it's up to the families now. It's up to the families to support and it's up to close friends and things like that to be there for the ones that are needed to be there for. But other than that, like I said, like, it doesn't matter what happens in the situation. There's, the two lives are always and forever going to be affected. And it's sad.
Yeah.
Right, guys. Angie's gone, probably gone to the toilet, I'm thinking. Does anybody else want to say anything?
Well, I just hope people can lay off him because, like you say, he's not really done anything wrong and he's getting penalised for everything. And it's
yeah, I think it's been a bit harsh on them, to be quite honest with you.
The comments that have been coming out of people's mouths is absolutely disgusting. And I've watched it since yesterday and all morning this morning. And I've been trying to get on his live in the box so I can defend him. Not saying if he was wrong, then I would not defend him, but I don't think he's done anything wrong.
Kelly, have you spoken? I've spoken, sorry.
Hi, no, I was just going to see if Angie had JC's video where he made the statement, if she has, if she could play it, because I've not seen it.
This is a statement from JC, you mean?
Yeah.
I'll play that again, one sec.
Oh, thanks, I've not seen it.
Are you going to play the full 7 minutes?
Huh?
Are you going to play the full 7 minutes?
Well, it is 7 minutes long.
Oh, wow.
I haven't seen it, one sec. I can't even find it now. Where have I done it? What have I done with it? Give me a sec. Oh, here it is. Here it is.
Person said that. What I've been accused of.
Oh, you can't see it. You only can hear it because I've got this up.
That's why I've gone to the police myself. It's now.
Is that
police.
Okay? It's only seeing me. You don't have to see it.
I don't want people from my side going to fucking her side or Birdman's side or whoever's side and start saying you've done this and you've done that. She came on live yesterday. She justified to everyone in the fucking boxes, I've not done what's been said. I just want my name clearing. That is it. I don't want to have to fucking come live every day and just have to sit to death of you, like, to be accused of something so fucked up and then have to keep hearing about it and talking about it and discussing it and everything else. I don't want to have to do. Yeah, I've reported it to the police. I've left it in their matters. I've told Alicia I've reported it to the police. And if she or anything feels like in any way, shape or form that she needs to go to the police, she can go to the police. But she's come on live yesterday and justified that I've not done what I've done. She's texted me and said I've not done what I've done. She spoke to me on the phone and said I've not done what I've done. I want to leave it at that. My head right now, I'm not in the right headspace to just be coming live and sat here and fucking doing my normal bits and bobs that I usually do. To be accused of something so messed up is crazy. I'm going to have a couple of days off. I'm just going to get my head around things. The scariest thing is losing my daughter. That's it. I'm not asked about my business. I'm not asked about my agency. I'm not asked about my other business. I'm not asked about losing my daughter over a false accusation. The difference is, I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, Birdman, you've done this, or she said this. She's come in, she's cleared my name, I'm leaving at that. I ain't going to come on and justify every day to people, new people coming in and new people talking about it live, saying, well, has he done it, has he not? She's come on his mouth and she said, I've not done what I've done. And I'm going to leave it at that. And I respect it if anyone from my side doesn't go into these people's sides going, justice for JC. I've cleared my name, I'm leaving it as that. I don't need people going to other sides saying you've done this, it's wrong, blah, blah, blah. I just want it left. I want to be left, I want to just come back and everything be back to normal. I've cleared my name, the main thing. I ain't going to sit on here saying he said this or she said this because I don't get involved with stuff like that. Personally, I generally feel fucking sick that I've had allegations made about this. But respectfully, I'm just having a couple of days off just to fucking just recuperate and just fucking get myself where I need to be. I ain't a pity party. I ain't gonna sit on here all day and like everyone feel sorry for me and everyone else to gift me. I'm not about that. I'm just gonna stay away from the app for a couple of days, just have a bit of fucking me time and just fucking come back down to reality, and then that's it. And thank you, everyone who believed in me anyway. And I ain't here for hey, or he's done this, and she's done that, I promise you.
I think she's live. Apparently, she's live, and she's saying that he's apologised to her and stuff like that. Can you come to her?
Yeah, one sec.
I don't know if it's you, though. It's just I'm reading the comments.
Yeah, is Zayana here?
Zayana?
Get in the box, Zayana. Where is she?
I'll have to drop somebody, guys.
I can drop. It's okay.
Well, I don't think she's even here, though. I know.
Well, she's here. She's here. Zayana's here.
Well, thanks, Angie.
Thank you so much. Guys, any gifts, send them to Zayana, guys. She's our cam too. Hi, Zayana.
Hello, morning.
I feel like we're you, Zayana.
You're singing a song about being pushed away.
What?
I don't know. I can't remember the words now. She's like, I trusted you and I pushed you away or something. I don't know. It sounds a bit dodgy to me.
She said JC knows what he did and apologised.
Guys, I don't know what you're all going on about. I've literally, JC's apologised to me for his actions. Do you know what I mean? Like, in his eyes, someone saying no, no, no is, do you know, like, in his eyes back then was okay. Because something happened after it. But I said I don't want to speak on the subject, and I'm getting all this. I'm getting everyone like, oh, JC's a nice guy. Like, JC, all JC, team JC, team JC. The end of the day, I had a phone call with JC yesterday, and he's apologised to me for making me feel that way. And that's all I need.
Making her feel that way.
So it was true.
He didn't grape her.
He said sorry because he didn't think back then her saying no, no, no was a problem because they did something afterwards.
So he apologised for making me feel that way.
So obviously something happened and she didn't. And then she felt some sort of
feel that way. Maybe he did something, not on the lines of that made her feel uncomfortable. Because obviously, if she said no and she's done da da da, then that's just not how you feel. That's 100% great, right? Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, but she said he apologized for making me feel that way. But then I can't remember what she said. But then something happened after.
When someone does something to you and you're saying no, 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 and they're continuing, that's not how you. That's not I apologize for making you feel that way. That's I apologize for graping you, right?
Yeah, she's very, very dangerous, Andy.
But making her feel that way, maybe there was nothing lying on the lines of that. But maybe he did kind of do something, right? Maybe like kind of even just grabbed her and she said no. Maybe in that way. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I agree with you, Angie. I think it was a situation where they were both possibly in the moment and maybe something happened.
And she's obviously dead.
Yeah, I mean, he could, like I said, he could have just grabbed her and she's gone no.
Yeah, and I think this is, she's...
And she felt uncomfortable. Because you don't use those words. I'm sorry for you making me feel that way. If it was great.
No, I'm so oh my god, that's actually
what she just said. She just said he didn't think there was anything wrong with it back then when I said no, no, no. But because we'd done something afterwards, he thought there was nothing wrong with it. But no means no.
Yeah.
So you're going to sleep with somebody or you're going to do something with somebody who's attacked you? Like, if somebody did something like that to any of us, I'm sure we wouldn't then go on to sleep with them.
It was on the same note. I think
something's happened between them, yeah? And she's felt a certain way. He's maybe made her feel that way, uncomfortable, right? And he didn't realise that, maybe. But I don't think, from what she's saying, it sounds like great. But I'm not saying it isn't. I'm not saying it isn't. Just to me, those words don't sound like you'd apologise for making you feel that way if it was something more severe.
No, you never know how somebody feels about a situation.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah. I don't know.
That's mad, that.
Maybe he was a man, he had a bit to drink and was groping, you know, kind of groping her a bit. Do you know what I mean? And she was like, no, no.
That's still assault, though, isn't it?
No, it is assault, but I'm just saying, we're looking at rape, man. Do you know what I mean? Do you get what I'm saying?
It's just so complicated.
It might not be as severe.
Well, the problem is, we all sit here and we say, oh, but that's assault, that's assault, that's assault. If they were out and about and they were hanging about and they were both having drinks, we don't know. Unfortunately, there's a horrible situation because we don't know whether she was jumping in his lap, giving him kisses on his cheek, hanging around his neck. Like, what happened in the aspects of before the groping? This is where so many people can speculate and it becomes a dangerous, dangerous situation. Because we also know it does also take two to tango and two to express feelings, you know? It's both ways. So she might say, oh, he made me feel uncomfortable because he groped me, but what was she doing on the night out beforehand to make him feel like he could do that? You know, I'm not saying that he should have done it if she didn't, but who's to say she wasn't giving the flirt out? You know what I'm trying to say?
I don't think you can say that because you're basically saying that if you're a flirtatious kind of person touching your feeling, you kind of deserve what's going to
exactly
No, no, because she was out the next day with him after all of this stuff happened.
That's not uncommon for a woman to have that bond with someone.
And when was it, a year ago?
I don't know if that's the right word to use, bond, but do you get what I'm saying? It's not uncommon for a woman to still talk to a man that's just done something to her the night before.
No still means no, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, but what's name, top girl? No means no, yeah, but does... I'm just saying some women do speak to their abuser the next day and act like...
I agree normal. With you, Andy.
When it happened, I didn't
want to
speak to my abuser.
And when was it?
I 110% agree with that, but that's the problem, isn't it? We're all speculating it on one side, and that's a shame because we don't know the other.
Yeah.
That's all I'm trying to say. Do you know what I mean?
That's JC's fault, though, because he's saying he doesn't want to talk about it, but then this girl keeps coming on live and talking in code.
It's a hard one, but if he's reported to the police, he might feel he can't talk about it. Do you get what I'm saying? So people are saying he's probably hiding because he's guilty. I'm not, but that's not fair either. Do you know what I mean? So he's gone to the police. He can't talk about it.
It's mad. What I thought. This girl is so...
How old is JC?
I can't see her going to the police.
What did he say, Ziana?
How old's JC?
I think he's my age, 30.
He must be in his 30s, 35 or something, no?
Is he?
How old is
she? She is only 20. So maybe she's... Yeah, maybe she's just too young and...
He's 30. Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe she wanted more from him and she, after the one night, didn't offer
it. Yeah, is he 30? He looks older than me.
36.
Me, I'm so glad I'm a bit brown. No wrinkles, nothing nice.
Yeah. So she's just singing now then?
Yeah.
He is 29.
She's just turning a corner.
Right, so people want to get in the box. Guys.
He turned 30. He just turned 30.
Right, I'm going to put some different people in, guys. Music. People that haven't had a say are going to go in first, okay?
Hi, Andrew.
Hiya.
Hi. I'm just going off, obviously, what DG said when he came in the box yesterday, that apparently, obviously, the day after, she was all over him and kissing and cuddling. I mean, everybody might feel different after that. That is completely everybody's right to feel completely different. But when I used to see my abuser, I ran in the opposite direction and I was cringed every time I saw that person.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously everybody feels different, but yeah, DG did say the day after she was all over him.
But that doesn't mean, you know what I mean?
You know,
there's still a no means no. You can still be over some, you know, all over someone. And
yeah, that's what I said, yeah.
Good afternoon, guys.
It's a hard one, isn't it?
Hi, Kay. Who's speaking? Kay?
No, it's Sunny.
Sunny, hi.
Sunny. So I watched this unfold from more or less the beginning. And from what Birdman showed on his live when it was all kicking off at first, that basically he showed that she had said that JC had done this. Now, JC has now gone to the police, but this is not the first time this girl has made allegations, you know, on these grounds. She's done it with somebody else last year.
Wow.
Yes, and, you know, it's known on the app that, you know, she done it with somebody else last year.
And someone 3 years ago I've saw in the comments.
So, you know, at the end of the day, I think JC has done the right thing from by going to the police. You know, this is, you know, it's not a very nice thing. You know, it could damage somebody. It could destroy, you know, somebody. And when it gets into the wrong hands, you know, if somebody believes, you know, that he's done such a thing, you know, he could become a target, you know, and that's the most dangerous thing about this. And, you know, women that do this, you know, should be punished in the same way as, you know, somebody would do if they had actually done what she's saying, you know.
But the thing is, though, Sonny, she's literally just come on and said, JC apologized to me. So some girls want like justice and stuff like that, and some girls just want
the thing is right. Say something has happened, right? It might not, but as we're thinking the worst scenario, right? But she's made it quite vague. She's made she's left it for people to think the worst. So why can't she come on and just say, "Listen, guys, he did not. She doesn't have to say what happened, but he did not do this."
Yes,
that's what everyone is thinking because of her video.
I think she's trying to drag it on for views in my eyes because obviously the other day I think she did mention something about that didn't happen and people that she was speaking to about it has exaggerated the situation, but now she's sat on live trying to...
It's on the FYP, isn't it?
You know what I think?
Of her saying that it didn't happen.
What did you say, Angie?
I think about all of this, yeah, by watching all these videos. You know, I honestly think, I don't think anything like that severe as to what I thought has happened, yeah? But I feel maybe he's groped her in a way, right? Gone out, had a bit to drink, and she's probably said, "No, can you not do that?" Or he's kissed her, and she said no, right? Or, you know, put his arm around. What maybe he was a bit too, you know, in the past.
Well, she needs to speculate.
That's made her feel. But she's made people think it's something to do with the grape.
It's more sinister.
Yeah, I agree.
I don't think that he apologised to her in the way that, you know, she's now saying that it's come across. Because yesterday, after, you know, before JC did his, like, you know, talk of him, you know, coming off for a couple of days, he said that he's gone to the police, he's going to let the police deal with it, which is the right thing to do.
When he phoned her, he recorded that conversation.
He recorded
because,
it.
Because, yeah, he might have phoned her for a reason. He might have phoned her because he probably knows what she's talking about, right? So he's probably phoned her for a reason. You know, he's got a police case right now. So this is what I would do. I'd phone that person to get that information out of that person that nothing severe happened. Tell, you know, blah, blah, blah. And he might have done that to it and recorded it.
Well, you know, the thing is that if something like that had happened, I know a lot of women don't initially open up about it because they feel, you know, sometimes it's, you know, feeling bad, and, you know, that it's happened to them. They feel, you know...
Some girls think that.
I don't think people could do really much about it either, because when you think about it, she didn't actually make an accusation against him. She didn't actually say the word grape.
She's saying as well that it wasn't that, and he's apologised for making me feel that it was. So I feel like you're right, like something did happen, but not like the full-on grape kind of thing, but something has happened. And
Maybe he's kind of got a bit leery out on a night out.
Yeah, touchy-feely kind of thing.
But, you know, I don't think he's got really much of a case. She didn't actually accuse him of grape. It was other people that said
then,
it.
You know, if they've gone out on a night out together... and something has happened, you know, was she just as much, you know, in that moment as what he was? Or, you know, we don't know, because she's not being very
honest.
Open.
Yes.
You know,
that's what I was trying to say earlier, like, how do, there's two sides to every story. How do we not know in that moment it was a both person thing? Do you know what I mean?
You know, and like I say, you know, it's known that she's done this before. Somebody in the chat said that she's done it 3 years ago as well. So how many times
can... Why is she saying that JC apologised to her then?
How many times can somebody... sorry, I'm just reading the chat.
Why is everyone saying ask DG? The thing is, though, it's not DG who's involved in this girl. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, why should we ask him if his friend apologised?
Someone has just said it was definitely during something.
She said no, 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 and cried all night, they said. This is what Birdman did say. He, as I watched it all unfold from about 2 o'clock yesterday morning, and said it was defo during something.
DG was there that night. Oh, was DG there that night?
DG was there that night. It was said on the live that DG was there that night, and I think that's why... He knew that nothing had gone on in that way. And, you know, I think that's why him and Birdman then have started, you know, the beef between them. You know, but then...
Guys, if you request in the box, let me know if you know this actual story and then I'll let you up. Because Angie's gone away.
You know, I wasn't there. I can only go by what I see.
DG says I wasn't there the first night, the second night I was.
I see what was unfolding. I went into the room... Birdman's room at about 3 o'clock in the
DG,
morning.
Do you want to jump up? I'm not going to force him to jump up because I think he said what he needed to say. I don't know, guys. It's just too... she's been very selective in her words, and she's just, I think she's goading everybody, and she's just not saying, coming out with whatever.
Yeah, she doesn't want to put it to bed kind of thing. She's making other people speculate on different things, but DG wasn't there that night. He turned up the morning after, from what he said in the box.
Okay.
And that's when he said he picked them both up, and they was in his car, and they was kind of like all over kind of thing.
Yeah, I cry when I'm drunk. Just shut up, man.
But I think people should start taking the heat off Birdman because he hasn't done anything wrong.
Yeah, I think Birdman needs to get left out of the whole conversation. Yeah. I think it's between JC and this girl now.
Yeah, he's done nothing wrong. I've been watching it over the last day or so. I've been watching it from when it first started last night to this morning, and the only thing that he has done is tell Rowanen. That's the only thing
now.
Other than that, the rest of it,
he's
done nothing wrong.
This girl is very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. What did Angie say?
Can you control who you put in? Just put
yeah, I'm going to tell people to drop off.
If she is not, drop off top girl. I don't know. If she is not
as well, then, you know, there should be
someone kick me out.
Legal punishment, you know, to this, because the thing is, it will set a precedent for other females not to lie in such a way, you know, to get the kind of attention or, you know, to get, you know, people into trouble that haven't done these things. And it also, you know, with people that it's actually happened to and the way how they have to deal with this, you know, they don't come forward. You know, because of, you know, people like this, you know. And the thing is, she's chopping and changing her story each time. I've heard three different versions so far, you know, of yes, it did happen, and then no, it's not happened. And now she's going back to saying she said no, no, no. What's all that about? Look, if she's going to sit down and tell a story, you know, she's got to sit down and say, look, this is what's happened, you know. But she's not being, you know, 100% sort of like upfront and direct with it, and I just don't believe it. I really don't believe it because of what I've seen, you know. And I am sorry to her if I am wrong, but you know, I don't think that she's carrying herself responsibly or in that way. But if she's got, like I said, if JC's gone to the police, it's now with the police. Let them deal with it, you know. But if she's got, yeah, so I just, you know,
yeah,
it's a hard one, but from what I've seen, I can't see that JC has done anything from what I've seen, you know, from being in the live stream the other day and yesterday at morning. It was about 3 o'clock in the morning that I got in there and seeing what was unfolding, and from what's been on the FYP with the video saying, you know, her saying that, you know, it didn't happen, and then all of a sudden it's now back on to it happened. So nothing's really clear. They've just got to let the police get on with it. You know, if something's happened, then, you know, they will find it.
Can I just go to Mammy whilst Andrew's eating? Sorry.
Hi, everyone. I was watching that girl's live just now before you streamed it, and she was asking for people to bring JC to her live. She was like, just bring JC and we will explain it. She went on to say then that what she told Birdman was true, and in a phone call with JC, he's admitted what she said happened, and he's apologised to her. Those were her words. My opinion on that is that I don't think anything bad has happened between them both. I think maybe he was a little bit eager. She's not a girl who's eager in those kind of activities. And then once he slowed down, he was consensual. That's what I got from what she just said on there. The other thing I wanted to pick up on earlier, Birdman was in the box saying that he spoke to her 2 months ago. She said on that live just now, she phoned Birdman the day after this happened, and that's when she told him. And he said, previous to 2 months ago, the last time he had contact with her was a year ago. Then Hustle said a year ago, she was accusing someone else. So is it Birdman that she was accusing, or was it someone else?
Because Hustle was Birdman, would have still been talking to her if she had accused him. Do you know what I mean?
Or was she insinuating and never named the person to Hustle? Because it's weird how they've gone 10 months with no contact.
Well, can you not please, like, it wasn't Birdman, like, let's not put out names, especially of the creators on the app. D-Lair, have you spoken?
No, not yet, I've just been listening.
Sorry, I'm so sorry, I thought you was there before.
I think it's been one of the most calmest times in this whole situation. What I just don't get is, if what's going on from what you said, Mummy, if what she said was true, and, you know, Birdman's held his hands up, he shouldn't have. I know we didn't go into detail, but he shouldn't. He probably got a bit of pressure if he didn't move it. He's held his hands up, you know. He shouldn't have said anything. So it has gone further from that. But prior to that, she said something.
I think it was Sonny. I've just muted the mic.
Sorry, can I just clarify? I wasn't accusing Birdman of anything. I genuinely like Birdman. I watch him. I was seeing, because I don't know the history of what was said before with the accusation.
No, Mommy, sorry, no.
That's why I was just trying to clarify.
Can we just have a 1 minute interval, please?
Yes, sure.
People just in the heart meets. Thank you very much.
Andrew, what are you eating?
I'm
Sonny, Andy was talking.
Yeah, so
no, sorry, I just said that I'm going to drop down now.
Oh, okay, sorry.
So somebody else can come up.
We have a 1 minute interval while we get the heart meters in. Thank you very much. And don't forget, guys, I've got hotlines here. What was it called? Protestant grape crisis. Sorry, I have to use the right word. Here, can everyone see that, guys? That number, yeah,
we can see it.
I can send it to whoever needs it. It's on Google as well, guys.
Can we start tapping the screen as well, guys? Please, let's get to 50k likes.
Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, Shah. Send, we're just doing a 1 minute interval, then we can restart it. Who are we talking to now, Top Girl?
It's going to be D-Lair is going to finish, and then it's going to be like coffee and this.
Yeah, do we end it after this, like these two people?
You can do. It's your life, Andrew. You shall we?
Well, Cockfield, you're the one that, in the morning, Miss Red's not on, can you jump on?
You know what it is? I wanted to go out early in the morning with my daughter.
Miss Red, because it's not good enough. I think she's becoming part-time.
And she is. Andrew, I heard she couldn't afford her Wi-Fi. That's why she went on, but that's just speculation as well.
So who are we talking to? Coffee?
No, D-Lair still talking.
Sorry, D-Lair, so I do apologise.
No, you're all right, it's fine. I just don't understand But is she aware of everything that's happened to Birdman? And she's literally just sat online seeing. That is literally all I wanted to say. Like, after everything that's happened in the last few days, and she's just on live singing. Like, I know she's got her own platform, she has every right to do her own thing, she's got her own viewers, she's got her own team. Like, a lot of it is now just hearsay. Like you said, Top Girl, earlier, we are just recruiting as well, you know?
And just, I think it just makes people, because she hasn't cleared anything up, you know? And if that was me, and I felt that things have, people got the wrong end of the stick, I would clear things up and say, listen, I don't need to tell my business, obviously, and say what happened. I don't have to say that, but I can clear one thing up and say it's not bloody great. Let's get real now. That's what people are thinking. Do you know what I mean? You know, by her that video saying, I know the truth, he knows the truth, blah, blah, blah. It's all speaking in goddamn riddle. She knows what she's doing, yeah? Right? I'm not saying she's not a victim. I'm not saying she is. I don't know because I don't have the evidence. But what she is doing, I can tell you, is not stating the truth, you know? And just saying, this. Listen, I'm not going to say what happened, but this did not happen. Now, if you don't say that, people are going to think it's the worst of the worst. And if, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just don't understand. Maybe, I don't know.
She's a very dangerous woman. Very, very dangerous woman, this girl is. And yeah. I don't care, like, everyone's saying she's 20. Me, I was pregnant at 20. Like, you know what you're doing.
So I know it didn't.
Messages that Birdman put up, was there any, and she goes, no, I said, no, no, no. Did she actually say, because, sorry, I can't remember now. You know, I get it.
Did she just repeat that as well? Diana's just saying that she just repeated that as well. That she said no, no, no.
Yeah, and that's all she said. Well, you don't have a conversation and say something happened between me and so and so, and all I said was no, no, no. Come on, that's not a conversation. Her man came on here and said she was implying grape.
What she said was he didn't think there was a problem with it because they did something afterwards, but she said no, no, no.
Right, so she's implying grape, right? I don't care how anyone looks at it. That is what you're implying, grape. You might not have actually said the word, but if you're saying no, 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 and you've done something after, as in sexually, then that is grape, right? And now, if that is not the case, she needs to come on here and clear it up. And it's simple enough. She needs to clear it up because this man needs to clear his name. Now, she's even saying he's apologised. Why would you even come on TikTok and say that? Because now you made it even worse by people thinking, oh, my God, he did it. Do you get what I'm saying? He did
say. And Shan said, can you check your snap?
Yeah, some portion has come to the TikTok. I'm not saying she needs to talk about her business, but at least clear his name and say, listen, it was not great. She needs to do that. And now, if you know, it was, because it's now on TikTok now. Just tell people. You know what I mean? Stop speaking in riddles and make people believe. Stop making people believe it is something like that. That I don't like.
It didn't start on live, but now it is on live and it is on TikTok. I really think that some of the arguments should end on live, and I think maybe she should maybe speak to Birdman, whether it's privately.
Another thing I think of, Dila, is that why would she tell Birdman? She isn't important. She didn't bring it to the app, did she? She was not bringing the app. She spoke to another person, which implies to me maybe something did happen, because why would you tell someone in confidence, which is what she's done, right? It wasn't her to report it to the app.
Yeah, but even then, since then, she checked on what she said and said that she didn't actually say that. So a lot of it is.
I don't know. She could be also scared of bringing it to TikTok.
That is the thing, isn't it? That is the thing. There's a lot to it that we just don't know. So it's just, I just don't understand, like, how the last few days it's been absolutely all on Birdman and she's just on live singing. Like, it just makes sense.
And Anne got to 101.6k followers. Yeah, I know she had loads of them followers before, but will she try and hit the 100 mark?
No, she's already had 100, Diana.
Yeah. Whether she said it or not, if there was actual fact or truth in anything she'd said, she would not feel, maybe the actress, but she would not hesitate to come into this box now or come into one of Angie's lives and actually put her side out there, but she's not done that once. Surely she knows that this is going on.
Yeah, exactly.
Can we go to coffee? Yes.
Hey, coffee. Hello, coffee.
Georgia, are you there?
Hello. I might be echoing, am I?
No, you're fine.
Hey, Georgia.
Hey, I'm not echoing.
No, you're fine.
Okay, so basically, I feel, fucking hell, it's a lot in it, but I just feel like obviously something has happened that night, and let's remember, not all victims of any of this situation, I'm not saying she 100% is because I wasn't there, but not a lot of them, people seem to deem rape as you're instantly pinned down and something happens to you. That is not how it happens. There's a lot more other situations that can happen for it to be classed as that. And a lot of women do refrain from saying that word. And to me, it sounded like, and that kind of sounds like what's unfolded today, and this is what I thought yesterday, basically she's obviously mentioned it to somebody without saying the words, which is why she said, I never said that, I never said that, I never said that. But then it sounds to me like that word has then been said back to her, and she's refrained from using that word. That's why she was saying, I never said that to Birdman, I never said that to Birdman, because she's quite clearly never said the word grape. And then obviously she's spoken to JC and explained how it made her feel. He's apologised for what's happened. She's stated, people have said that it can be this, da 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 da. And then he's apologised. She's chose not to bring it to the app, and she's not going to say her truth, because at the end of the day, it's a fucking sticky situation. They was out the next day. And then that doesn't mean somebody's lying as well. Like, I can hand, like, that does not mean somebody's lying. That's exactly what I think's happened. Clearly something has happened. Okay, she may have said no, no, no. Whether something happened afterwards or not, it doesn't mean to say, like, how she felt in that situation. I think something's happened. Then obviously he's apologized for it and finally heard about how she felt about the situation. And regardless, as no matter what anybody says, whether Birdman says it wasn't brought to the app by him or JC going in the live, by him having an argument with her prior, and her, by Birdman arguing with her in the box, them two arguing back and forth, and him going, have the same energy for JC after what he done to you. I don't care what anybody says, he brought it to the app first. That's how it got back to JC, for JC to even rise in anyone's box and speak about it. Does that make sense? So, as much as Birdman saying he didn't bring it to the app, he did, for JC to even respond by him saying that to her.
JC only brought it to the app once the hustle called him.
The reason, as DG said when he was arguing Birdman, the reason JC come to the app about it was because he heard what Birdman said to her in the box, and it obviously is going to go back to him. So for you to even argue with a woman and then turn around and say to her, have the same energy for JC after what he done to you, is absolutely disgusting. Yeah. She clearly didn't bring it to the app in the first place. And why would you say to a woman who's told you something in confidence, and she's quite clearly saying she never said that word, and he's using that word, like, why would you turn around and say to a woman, have the same energy to JC after what he done to you? That has come onto the app by Birdman for JC to even speak about it. And that's what DG was trying to say to him. Like, Birdman was saying to him and manipulating the situation by saying, oh, JC was the one who mentioned it on the app first, and DG was going, no, because you had her in your box and you said his name. Yeah, okay, but he's instigated, have the same energy. Do you know what I'm saying? And I just also think, like, it's really important to remember, when women do go through this, it's not as clear as day as, like, you're being forced into something at all. Like, you're not being forced into something, and just because you're with the person who done it to you the next day, it can take years of speaking to friends and speaking to people to realize when you've said stop or no, or even if it's happening or it's prior and it's eventually happened, that there is something there that you wasn't in your mental capacity, or you're saying no. Does that make sense? Whether you change your mind or not, like, and for men as well, to protect themselves, if a woman says no to you, even if she then puts it on you, don't do it.
Yeah.
So that's also important for men to remember, because a lot of men are like, well, it was a no initially, but then it happened consensually. Men need to also remember, if at any point that woman has said no,
I feel like girls sometimes do it just for the sake of doing it, because, like, they've said no and no, and they're not taking it. Let's just do it before. I don't know. It's just
all different scenarios. Some women just give in because, one, they feel threatened, one, because they just decide they do want to do it. They might be playing hard to get. There's all different situations, and that's why it's actually such a hard thing to prove. Like, as people know, that you don't. It's very common that you don't get justice for it, and a lot of people don't even bother reporting it when it's in the past. But I do think there can be a lot of situations to it. But it is really important to remember, just because somebody's out with somebody the next day and laughing or something like that, does not mean they may then wake up sober and think to themselves, I wish that never happened, and I do remember saying no. So, like, I weren't there, I don't know, but I'm just giving you different like parts of it, but men also need to remember for their own protection, if she says no at any point, don't even do it, whether she does it consensually, because so many men get falsely convicted because at some point in the night the woman said no. And men need to protect themselves just as much as women do.
Yeah, 100%.
And here's another one. You've got to remember, guys, she did this for a job.
Call free on blind as a bat. Can you read that?
0808 500 2222.
Can I just say one thing, Top Girl, to Georgia? Where's the same energy towards the two girls? All about Birdman, but where's the same energy? Birdman went in confidence because he didn't know what to do with the information. Was it to Rihanna? And Rihanna was the one that went to JC with it. So yeah, that's how it came onto the app. It wasn't Birdman that brought it to the app.
Right, so, but prior to that situation, he had an argument with the woman who's involved in this situation in his box prior to him speaking to Rihanna and said to her, have the same energy for what JC done to you. So regardless, it being mentioned on this app versus him.
No, what,
I'm not Rihanna. If I personally heard that, well, I'd fucking put myself in any position not to hear that, but it got brought to it by Birdman first. You can't say it didn't, because by him saying on a live stream, when he does have nearly a million people, have the same energy for what Jay-Z done to you.
But no, Georgia, the thing is, though, I just feel like this is a whole deflection from the actual situation. Like, she's literally just come on live and said, Jay-Z's apologised to me.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I don't give a fuck about the Birdman situation. It's out. Whoever fucking bought it to the app, I don't give a fuck at this point. She's literally just come on live and said, JC has apologized to me for making me feel this way. Do you know what I mean?
So making me feel like it wasn't completely consensual, clearly.
Yes, exactly. It's mad, absolutely mad. Like, we're still talking about who bought it to this stupid fucking app.
Yeah.
And Birdman did. Can I just say something, Claire? Sorry. Birdman did. When he was talking to somebody about it on live, he did admit that he did say JC's name to her in the box. He has said from his own mouth, he said, have the same energy for what JC done to you. And he's admitted he shouldn't have said that. He did say JC's name. So for people saying he didn't, he did. And if anybody's watching that, you're instantly going, if Angie come on here and said, argued with Corey and said, have the same energy for what Pell done to you.
But he didn't say what the situation was. He could have been a fucking argument.
Yeah, and then JC
could have been it could have been back and forth on TikTok, like on a battle.
And that was a week and a half ago.
Okay, after him reaching out to Rihanna for advice, does it matter if it was before or after? Does it actually
I just think Rihanna's done the wrong thing by running to JC, and she should have gone to the victim who's claiming to be a victim.
Yeah, we all deal with these situations different. I mean, some people have even gone to the police when it's happened to them, some haven't. Like, you know, it's not
from the bottom. You can be a girl going out and just have the same guy look at you every now and again, and that makes you feel uncomfortable, but you don't consent to that. Like, there's so many levels of being intimidated when you're a girl or a man. So regards to them two, it's like, I don't understand why she's come out saying JC's apologized when she's been also fighting the argument that she said nothing at all. As long as Birdman's not involved in it anymore, I'm not really that fussed. Like Birdman, and another thing, Georgia, Birdman did come on earlier and apologise for the things he said, but it wasn't him that brought it on live. Birdman came on live, I watched the whole thing, and just kind of like fought out loud with his team and said, look, I'm not saying this, I'm not saying that, but what do you guys think? And then it was, I think Rihanna that then went into someone else's box or Hustle's box or something. Then it got brought to Birdman's live while he was in his own live. Then Birdman blocked Rihanna, and then it went on from that. So it was kind of like already spoken about on TikTok before Birdman brought it to his live.
Oh, did he block Rihanna because she went back and mentioned it to Jay-Z?
Yeah, he did, yeah. And they actually spoke about an hour ago, and it was quite civil. So I feel like those two may, you know, have a conversation and apologise to each other, because they didn't apologise to each other in front of everybody.
I don't know, just telling a stranger as well is so weird. Like, it's, say for instance, if somebody here come and told me that, I would never then turn around and say to my moderator, who I don't fucking know from Adam, who is quite clearly moderator for loads of other people on this app, that Hustle and Birdman do not see eye to eye. I wouldn't then mention it and then say the name.
No, but like, Birdman said that they were talking already about something like that anyway, and it just came into conversation. So we don't know that conversation, and I don't think Rihanna or Birdman want to speak about that other conversation. So it just come into conversation. Birdman didn't mention no names at that point, and then I think Rihanna wanted to know because obviously she supports a lot of people, and she didn't want to gift somebody who had been accused of that or something. I don't know. I think that's the gist I'm getting.
Yeah, basically, Rihanna kept begging for him to tell her who it was in case she was gifting somebody like that.
Right.
So she was on and on at him. Anyway, I'm going to drop. Have a lovely day, guys.
Have a good day, Claire.
Bye-bye,
thank you for my 5 coins.
Love you. Bye.
What time do you love me, you weirdo? What a weirdo.
I don't know. She said she didn't beg for it. Like, apparently he was willingly giving the information. But the truth is, none of us are ever going to know the truth. The same as so many things that happen on this app, you're never, ever going to know the truth. Because say if JC gave his side and then she gave her side, people are going to see it from different perspectives anyway. Some people are going to say, that doesn't seem that great. And then some people can go, it definitely was. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
Somebody said, come up in a minute, guys. But as Jelly, the belly...
No, she hasn't. Say? She just come in.
No, I just wanted to say, and just a couple of things. Number one, I agree with Top Girl. We're past the point of who brought it to the app. That point's now a moot point. It's completely irrelevant. But also just a couple of generalised points. You know, the way some of these comments are moving is crazy when it comes to talking about victims of rape and SA and, you know, the way they behave. Oh, she's the TikTok bike, blah, blah, blah. None of that matters. None of that means that it's not possible that she is a victim of rape or SA. And comments like that are why people don't come forward and why people are afraid to come forward. I agree with lots that's been said. It shouldn't have been brought to the app. It shouldn't be being discussed on the app, which is hypocrisy as I'm sat here discussing it, but it's just in a generalized manner. Do you know what I mean? It's just, there's so much weirdness going on. And like, also the way people are willing to like get in boxes and ride hard for somebody that they don't actually know. Well, I know it wasn't JC, because, and I'm not saying it is JC, but, you know, oh, it's not JC because I've watched a couple of lives and he wouldn't behave like that. You know, there's some freaking moron in the comments said, oh, well, JC's not short of offers, so he wouldn't need to do that. What does it matter how much fanny you've got being thrown at you? Grape isn't about how many offers you've got. It's 100%. About power. It's got nothing to do with how many offers you've got.
Guys, I think we need to remember that there's going to be girls and boys out there that have gone through this, and it's really sensitive. Like, people are just so open to talk about rape, like it's just this easy conversation to have. Like I said, it literally starts from the bottom up. Like,
say grape because you'll probably get
word. But you can literally have, like, being a girl myself, I've had it numerous of times. You can go out and literally have this handful, like a certain men, like, on you. They don't leave you alone, and they think that's okay. They think they're being a gentleman, or they want to buy you a drink, and it could be literally not in the right place. They've got no bad intentions, but you're that girl or you're that boy looking at them thinking, like, I don't want you around me, leave me alone. And literally, Jake, it could have just started from something as small as that, and it's escalated to great. Like, I just don't understand. Like,
Andrew, somebody called Tammy saying she sent you an email.
Yeah, I'm on here. I'll have to read when I come off.
All I think, Andrew, right, is I think the bottom line is nobody knows. I'm sure there were, and I'm not putting JC anywhere near Anthony Q line, but I'm sure that there were a shit ton of people talking about what a great guy he was and how we would never have done what he did. You know, people don't know. That's it. You don't know. So don't come in and write hard.
Do you remember that guy who had a whole fucking family on the app and then he got sentenced for...
Yeah, that's what I'm on about, Top Girl.
Madness.
It's just mad. You know, and I like... Nobody knows who to believe, but I think the bottom line is, from a personal point of view, while I don't agree with false accusations, I would rather be on the side of believing a victim that lied about elements of it than believing a rapist that didn't tell the truth, if that makes sense.
And the hate going both of our sides, to me, I truly, truly, truly believe is crazy. Because it's literally people sitting on the internet that have absolutely no fucking idea whether it happened or whether it didn't happen. So to even look at it from a perspective of believing or not believing somebody because you watch their live is insane. That's insane.
That's just what I find crazy, Georgia. Like this, so even just this morning, so many people come up in the box, so many people in the comments, oh, JC would never, you know, and like I said, I'm not saying whether he has or he hasn't. Nobody knows. There's only two people that know what went down. All that shit about JC knows from her, JC knows the truth, Birdman don't know the truth. He weren't there. Birdman knows what she's told him.
Thank you.
Right, can we shut this down now, guys? Because I have been on since 10 talking about this.
Nobody cares, Ange. Top Girl wants you to stay on.
I do want her to stay on, but I really do want this subject to be
talked about. I'm really tired now. I think it's been kind of just going around in circles. Do you know what I mean?
Emma, the lady's just...
Subject
look at how we feel. You can only imagine how Birdman feels. Look at how we feel when we're just talking about it. Birdman's literally had 2 days of constant slating on live. Like, he's actually handled it really well, I think. He's been so calm.
Yeah, he had a body on him.
Well, yeah, apart from that, like, mad hour, but...
Right, guys, if you can stay in the boxes if you don't talk about it. Or I'm dropping yours. I know it's Angie's list. Look, they're all dropping like flies because they just want the drama.
Go on, drop me.
Peace.
If you want to get in, we're not talking about the goddamn, what was it? I don't even know what we're talking about.
You just carry on eating your strawberries. Did you get more food delivered?
No, because I lost my card. I can't find it. I had to order shopping from online on the internet. No.
Oh, poor you. What bank are you with?
Santander.
You can get your bank details from the app on Santander.
Well, I have to block it, though, don't I? The card.
No, because it's going to be at home, isn't it?
Yeah, it's at home somewhere, but I need a card, though, don't I?
Mine are saved on my phone. Just click a button and it all goes in.
Yeah, I don't know if you do that. So you don't have an actual card, the bank card, Zona?
No. I've got my bank card, but I just click a thing on my phone, like how you'd save your password and you just click it and it puts your password in for you. But I've got one from a bank and I just click it and it puts my bank details in for me.
Well, I feel like I need to block the card anyway, do you know what I mean? Just in case. Yeah.
Or freeze it, because last time you found it, didn't you? Can't you freeze
it? How's it going, Pearl? Do you want to get in the box?
Can't you freeze your card, Ange?
Zion, do you want to give me your bank details?
Yeah, because there ain't enough in there for you to be happy.
Pearl!
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
How are you feeling, Pearl?
I'm good now. I've had like a couple of days. Wednesday I come off. I've had a couple of days, but I've had withdrawal symptoms from the energy. Withdrawal symptoms from the body. No.
That was a long discussion.
Are we having bumbles and drama tonight?
Andrew only drinks on a Wednesday and a Saturday. Do you not remember?
Sometimes she changes her day, she said.
Are you having a drink tonight, Angie, or not?
I don't know. When are you having a drink, Pearl?
Tonight. I need a drink tonight.
Oh, I'll have one tonight. Woo! I do actually have a bottle of wine too sitting there, actually.
No, I need a drink tonight. So.
I'm going to have to get a bumble, though.
Have you spoke to Lynn's, Ange?
Yeah,
she okay?
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Corey.
Corey, are you forgetting my Interstellar?
Corey got his gyro today, Pearl. That's why he's splashing out.
Oh. He lives in that council house with the cladding.
Hi, everyone. Yes, we've got the green team back on tonight.
I will be going to sleep at 7 because I do not want to be involved in the madness.
No, we have a few drinks. I need a drink. We are going to have a few drinks and we'll run some games together, eh?
Yeah.
You want to?
Yeah, definitely. Let's do some battles.
The only thing, do you think we're going to
get into trouble.
Hopkill.
Oh, golly.
Hopkill.
I'm scared. I don't want to say hello.
Yeah, don't. I wouldn't if I was you either.
I'm sorry. I don't know it's what I've done.
Sorry. It's all right. It is what it is.
I don't even know what I've done to you.
You know what Corey did last night? It was absolutely, I was so affected by it. I thought it was really out of order.
What did he do?
He decided to put on a nun's outfit.
I know, it was disgusting.
He was wearing, and then he burnt a nun's outfit, man.
No, I didn't. Oh, don't yes, start. No, I didn't.
And he had a man in his bed last night.
I did have a man in my bed, that is right.
That is haram.
Yeah, I had a boy around last night.
Are you married?
No.
I haven't seen him long. Did you, Corey?
Yeah.
What's his name? Have you been seeing him long?
Well, long enough, Bill. Yeah, you know what I mean.
What do you mean, so about 2 hours?
Right, Top Girl, I don't know what your hatred is towards me, but it's always one-sided.
Corey, I love you. What are you on about?
Every single thing I do, you comment on it.
Why are you lying? Exactly.
You say a boy on this app. No, luckily, Jess Kerry's not on this app, so it's all right.
Are you going to let him come to the app?
I think you should do a
surprise reveal tonight.
Oh, no, we don't want... No.
Have you seen him again tonight?
Sunday suit. Look at that. In the comments, Corey Wild, Corey Nun Wild.
Are you seeing him again tonight?
Yeah.
So you won't be on the app?
No, I'm on tonight.
Oh. No, he comes on the app still.
Always.
Leaves him in the bedroom.
Oh, where's he going to... That's rude.
Somebody said it's Rickster.
It is not Rickster. He's a God-botherer now, isn't he?
So were you from last night?
May God bless you all. Thank you, Corey's Nan, for popping in. Big up to you.
Oh, my God.
You know, Corey messaged me yesterday.
Pearl?
Yeah?
Corey messaged me yesterday saying, can you leave me alone? And I've not even done anything to him.
Let Pearl just say what she said. Go and say it again, Pearl.
Don't get it. Going back on my Millen.
No, it's not Millen.
Millen.
That's a very strong no, though, Corey.
Have you been in a relationship before?
No, never. Not with Millen, no.
Oh.
Are you sure?
A nice couple. Mm-hmm.
Well, what was he singing about you the other day, then?
I don't know.
Corey, I'm sure
Corey,
you can
give it to me hardcore tonight. That's what you're singing.
Yeah, he said he was going to take half my money, wouldn't he?
The Brighty Jack.
Guys, we have a one-minute interval game, please. Can we have the heart moves? Thank you very much. Let's go with the heart moves.
We have to do a one-minute silence last night for Hustle and Angie's breakup.
Have you broke up with him already?
A breakup?
Yeah.
What the fuck have I missed?
We had to do 1 minute silence. No one could talk, chat, nothing.
Wow. And you spill the beans, you fecker. You've never told you when the soul has got it on. Oh, yeah. He dumped me for a woman. I have another woman. I can't believe it.
Oh. What's your new name on your other account, Ange?
We did a battle. We had a big battle. My name is called... Oh, God.
Corey, was it Luke?
That's a sugar mama.
Corey, was it Luke? Corey.
Yes, Tokyo.
Was it Luke? Yeah.
Mm-mm.
Luke's on holiday.
1 minute. He's not even saying no, guys.
Is there a smoke in? No, it's not.
That's what I'm trying to say. That's how I was more and so. They dropped me for, he dumped me for a woman.
What are you?
Huh?
What are you?
I'm straight.
What? What the fuck is wrong with you?
No, it's his mod. It is not my mod, Wes. All my mod are women. You all noticed?
I was his mod and he demodded me.
I did.
On camera.
No. He's been in the background, like he's spoken and stuff on live.
John Field.
A couple of months.
Nice. Does he live near you?
Yeah. He's like about 10 minutes away.
I can't wait to get some buzz boots. Have you done the deed?
Pardon?
Girl, you're muffled. We can't really hear you.
No. Can you, is that better?
Yeah.
Have you done the deed? Yeah.
Obviously, Bill.
Thank you, Jill.
Oh, well, then, so it's a proper relationship. It's not just like...
But Percy's just lied to us because he's saying a couple of months, but weren't he just with that guy a month ago?
What guy?
The one that you were split up with, that you was with for a while.
Yeah, that's right.
Excuse me, you can sleep with multiple people. You don't have to be in one relationship.
Well, you was in a relationship with that guy.
You're going to get called Dirty Corey now.
Oh, Corey.
Look, yeah, it is what it is.
So you put yourself out. Corey.
Oh, guys, why are you all so concentrated on me?
Because we care.
We want to make sure it's the right one.
Yeah.
You sound like the vaccine. I'm the girl.
Who's the male version of M's? I don't
know. By the way, guys, I'm changing my phone number today, so remind me to send you a new number.
Why are you changing it?
People just keep calling me on it.
You're for fuck's sake.
So,
Corey's the valley's bike. Yeah, something like that.
So you're not in a proper relationship then?
No, at the end of the day, I've got about 5-6 boys.
Yeah.
That, you know, we meet up and walk, yeah.
Do the deed.
Have you got more blood than you? You just doubted
yourself. We're all single now.
Yes, buddies.
Oh, well.
Have you got more blood than you? Because you just doubted yourself.
Friends with benefits.
We need to get Pearl a boyfriend now.
No, you don't need to get me a boyfriend at all. Thank you very much.
I saw your doctor's report and it said you're lacking in vitamin D.
Okay, now. What time are you going on tonight, Ange?
Whenever you're ready.
I'll be going on about 7 o'clock time, eh?
Oh, okay.
Can you refer to your side pieces as men, Corey, and not boys? Because there's a big problem with
that. That's a Welsh thing. That's a Welsh thing, that. Boys, isn't it, Corey? Corey?
If you're not going to talk, I'm going to drop you.
Corey, send me a gift before I drop you.
Excuse me, I sent you 500 on my other account and you didn't even say thank you. Thank you very much.
500 coins. That's like £2.
And?
Should he send you all big things? He doesn't send me big things. But I've just said thank you for me teddy bear. Thanks.
Yeah, he's got a big thing from what he said last night. He measured it with the ruler.
Oh, yeah, he probably added a few inches to that.
What the fuck?
He asked us, so Hustle didn't know, so he replied what his was.
Devon, I've been off 2 days from Wednesday. It's Friday now. I just need
you to be quiet.
If you fucked up life out.
If none of you like me, then why the fuck do half of you follow me? It's weird as fuck.
I like you. I like your dimples.
Who said you don't like it?
All these fucking comments, but they all follow me. They're all fucking bunch of weirdos.
Corey, stop disrespecting Angie's followers.
Well, technically, they might if they follow me.
Can you do that in your own life? No negativity. Pearl, shout at him.
No negativity. Exactly.
No negativity. Drama dumping costs 1,000 coins.
I just follow you. No, that's because you're blocked, Connie, and you'll always be blocked.
Hey, leave my Connie alone. Why is she blocked?
I love you, Steve Andy. She's always blocked.
Oh, I love Connie. Leave her alone.
Leave my Connie alone, please.
His one dimple. I have two dimples.
Justice for Connie.
Is it?
I have really big dimples.
I have one.
Wow. Yeah, I think that's why I like people with dimples, because I have really big ones.
Yeah. Oh, that's what you fancy top girl of.
Yes, Angie, because I thought if me and you have a child together, they would have dimples, because my son, my husband doesn't have dimples.
I love yours too.
So,
Corey, are you having a drink tonight, Corey?
No.
Why?
Because I'm not. I don't drink, Bill.
No, yes,
no, you know he only does that.
We'll have all the dimples, guys.
He only does the sugar. The what? The sugar. What's that? Oh, the pop. The powder.
Oh. Snowflake emoji for Corey.
Oh, thank you, Evil Liz.
Are you Corey?
No.
I thought you were on about just pop.
For fuck's sake, Phil.
No, it's on the cherry Aiden. What is it? What was the one last night, Corey? Confession time.
Can I ask you guys, can I ask you a question, Corey? Because you know it. I wouldn't have a clue when it comes to this subject, right?
Yeah.
Would you die, yeah, if you smoked cocaine?
No, man.
Why would I know the answer to that?